A splint is any device used to stabilize a fracture or dislocation. Improvised splints can be made from such items as a newspaper, a magazine, a pillow, heavy cardboard, wood, or a folded blanket. A self or anatomic splint is one in which the injured body part is tied to an uninjured part. For example, an injured finger can be tied to an adjacent finger, or the legs can be tied together. A rigid splint can consist of a board. A soft splint, such as a blanket, can be used to splint an injured ankle. You may not realize it, but in remote locations, you may have with you a lot of items which will help you in a severe medical situation.
Equipment designed for one thing can often be used for another. The key is to use your imagination and learn about some simple techniques before you leave for a remote location.
Simple items may be very useful in an emergency situation.
Duct tape. This well-known wide silver tape is one item that will help in bandaging. It can also hold a dressing in place. Use it to secure splints, such as ski poles, canoe paddles, or tree limbs to the victim's body.
A closed cell or Ensolite foam pad, often used as a sleeping pad. Ensolite can also be used in splinting. Wrap it around an injured knee or ankle to stabilize a sprain and secure it with duct tape. Even if you sleep on a self-inflating mattress, carry a small amount of closed cell foam to be used as a splint.
Safety pins. These have a variety of uses. To create an arm sling, pin the victim's shirt sleeve to the chest of the shirt. This will stabilize the arm until proper medical attention is received. If the victim is wearing a short-sleeved shirt, wrap the front of the shirt over the arm and pin the bottom hem to the chest of the shirt. Safety pins can also be used to remove a sliver from the skin, drain an abscess or blister, hold a bandage in place, or relieve a hematoma under a fingernail. Large sizes, number 3, are preferred.